or pin stoppage at Rameshwaram station. So what was the impact of this emergency? That Rameshwaram halt of the train, it was suspended. It means that train was no longer stopping at Rameshwaram station. So naturally, when the train is not stopping, the railway business was being affected because many of the things they were being transported trains from other places, including food items, including other goods which are required for a ride, and moreover, many other transactions they have come to an end. So naturally, this affected their state. The newspapers now have to be bundled and thrown out from the moving train on the Rameshwaram road between Rameshwaram and Thangpur. So naturally, the newspaper were being circulated there. Earlier, the train stopped and a person used to deliver the bundle of the newspaper to the concerned person. But now, when this suspension was held, train was not stopping. But it is not like that. It is not like that that someone has to collect. Then ultimately, the bundle of the newspaper, it has to be thrown out of the running train, where it is not at Rameshwaram station, but between Rameshwaram and Dhansukodi. Dhansukodi is the nearby place. Yes, Lavina, want to ask something?
Ma'am, I want to say that your voice is not coming properly.
Okay, I'll just see.
Ma'am, voice was slow.
Okay. So now it will be okay. Mic was little bit farther. Now I think it's clear. Okay, fine. Right. So, students are still entering the class. I don't know why. Now, afterwards, the newspapers now had to be bundled and thrown out from the moving train on the Rameshwaram road between Rameshwaram and Dhansukodi. This I have told, that now the newspapers, they have to be thrown out. Where they have to be thrown out? They have to be thrown out between Rameshwaram and Dhansukodi. Maybe Dhansukodi be the adjoining area. And that caused my cousin Samshudin, who distributed newspapers in Rameshwaram, to look for a helping hand to catch the bundle, and as if naturally I filled the slot. So now his cousin Shamsuddin, he was looking for a person who would catch that bundle of newspapers and would distribute and would bring to the town. So he said, as I was needing need of job and I want to earn money, so I filled the slot. Means I told him that I will collect the bundle of the newspapers and would bring to the town. Just a moment, please. Yes. Next, afterwards. And he said, I filled the slot. Shamsuddin helped me to earn my first wages. Half a century later. So here the point is, when he has earned his first wages. So when he has earned his first wages, he has earned his first wages when he was collecting, or when he used to collect the bundle of the newspaper, which has to be thrown out of the running train between Rameshwaram and Dhansukodi, as due to World War II, or as due to outbreak of World War II, emergency was declared when India joined Allied forces and there was suspension of the halt at Rameshwaram. And there was suspension of the halt of the train halt at Rameshwaram. So it means that this is the first wages that he has earned. So if somebody will, if the question usually asked in the exam that when he has earned his first wages, students usually write on when he is collecting tamarind seeds. No, here it is clearly mentioned in the chapter when he has earned his first wages. So I don't think so any confusion now. Okay, so you won't write it that when he has. So you won't write it that when he has sold tamarind seeds. No, it will be wrong. So when he has collected his first wages, it was at that time when he was collecting the newspaper which were thrown out of the running train between Rameshwaram and Bhansukodi. And at that time, what happened? India emergency declared and there was suspension of the halt at Rameshwaram as India joined Allied forces. So, half a century later, I can still feel the surge of pride in earning my own money for the first time. So, after 50 years, he's saying, I still have the feeling that I have earned my first wages. I have earned my own money for the first time. And he said, whenever I remember this, of earning my first wages, what he said that I am always filled with pride. My heart is always filled with pride. And I always feel that how hard work I have put in to collect those newspapers and to collect my and to gather my money. So any doubt in this paragraph, if you have, you can raise up your hand. That's fine. Okay. So next afterwards, paragraph number 4. See how para-wise he is shifting the detail. Every child is born with some inherited characteristics into a specific socio-economic and emotional environment and trained in certain ways by figures of authority. So every child, so you know that from your home also, from your house, many values you are learning from your parents, from the daily conduct of the household activities, daily conduct of the business in the house, okay, with the maid, with the people who are coming to your house. You have learned many qualities from there also. It is not only that you are coming to school and you are learning values, but many of the things you are also learning from your house. And he said, this is the reason why he said that every child is born with some inherited characteristics. So this is the reason why he said he was born with some inherited characteristics, because those characteristics are actually, you can say, they are actually present in his father and mother. And since childhood, as he was looking at them, so he has inherited those characteristics. Otherwise, these biologically, if we talk about, these characteristics cannot be inherited. What he means is this. Okay? So, into a specific socio-economic. Socio-economic means related to his social life as well as money. Economic. Okay? So, this is what I have told you, the kind of, you can say, money business or the money you can transaction that has been going on at home. And emotional environment and what kind of feelings were shared by his parents. He has also learned those feelings from them and trained in certain ways by figures of authority. And at some of the times, what he said, I was trained by figures of authority, means I have some authority. Authority means to have control over those. I inherited honesty and self from my father. So what are the qualities that he has learned from his father? It is honesty and self-discipline he has learned from his father. So what he said that he has learned honesty and self-discipline from his father and from my mother, I inherited faith in goodness, deep kindness, and so did my three brothers and sisters. And from his mother, he has learned the qualities to have faith in goodness. Faith in goodness, as her mother used to feed number of persons who are coming to their house without any discrimination, and what feeling she has in mind while serving those people, that she believes in goodness. It means she believes in the policy of do good and have good. She knew that these are the acts of karma which she is going to repay in her future life. So this is the reason why she believes in faith, in goodness, and deep kindness. Kindness, I have told you, because the number of people who are going to eat at their home, they are actually more than the number of family members. So, and his brothers and sisters, they have also learned these qualities of goodness, kindness, discipline, and honesty from their parents, that is father and mother. I had three close friends in my childhood. He has not mentioned much about his brothers and sisters, but he has made a special mention of his three friends with whom he has shared his childhood. What he said about his friends, Ramanand Shastri, Aravindam, and Shiv Prakash. So as he was belonging there to Telugu background, so does the names of all the three friends. What were the names of the three friends? Ramanand Shastri, Aravindam, and Shiv Prakash. It means nobody was of Muslim origin or Muslim background. All the three friends of APJ Abdul Kalam were Brahmins. And all of these boys were from Orthodox Hindu Brahmin families. Yes, Orthodox means strict in belief of Brahmins. No, you can say change in thoughts of Brahmins. So strict Orthodox, strict belief in Brahmin heritage. So this is the reason why he said they were from Orthodox Hindu Brahmin families. As children, none of us ever felt any difference amongst ourselves because of our religious differences and upbringing. So, but as children, we have never faced any kind of difference in our upbringing. He said it has never mattered that whether we are Muslims or they were Brahmin, so there was change in our upbringing, or there was change in the values that are going to be delivered to them as young children, or there was any kind of discrimination. No, he said, no, there was not any. In fact, Ramanand Shastri was the son of Pakshi Lakshman Shastri, the high priest of Rameshwaram temple. Later, he took over the priesthood of Rameshwaram temple. So, as Ramanand Shastri, he was the son of the greatest priest or the highest priest of Rameshwaram temple. So after his father, he has taken over the priesthood. It means this is natural. This is, you can say, but natural that a child has to follow his father's profession in order to carry forward his father's profession. This is the reason why he has taken the priesthood of Rameshwaram temple after his father. And Aravindam, he went into the business of arranging transport. So what Aravindam did, he was involved in business of arranging transport. So what business he was involved, he has started up a business of arranging transport for visiting pilgrims, and Shiv Prakashan became a catering contractor for Southern Railways. So the three friends, they have started their different businesses. So what Aravindam was doing, he has started a business of transport for pilgrims in order to pick and drop them. And moreover, Shiv Prakashan, what he became the catering contractor for Southern Railway. Now, during the annual Sri Sita Ram Kalyanam ceremony, this is the special occasion related to Lord Rama and Sita. Our family used to arrange boats with a special platform for carrying idols of Lord from the temple to the marriage site situated in the middle of the pond called Ram Tirath, which was near our house. See here various examples of communal harmony they have been given. So the first example was that there was not any kind of discrimination among these children. Okay, so as a Muslim boy, APJ Abdul Kalam has shared his schooling, his childhood days along with three Brahmin friends who were strict in their or who were orthodox in their Brahmin belief: Ramanand Shastri, Shiv Prakashan, and Subramanyam. Shiv Prakashan and Aravindam, sorry. But moreover, he said there was not any kind of difference between their upbringing. It doesn't matter that although they belong to different religions, but there was not any difference in their upbringing. So, next what he has mentioned is that during annual Sita Ram Kalyanam ceremony, this is a special occasion occasion of celebration for Hindu families or Brahmin families. But during that time also, what he's saying that our family was completely involved in arranging a boat, because near their house there was a pond, and they have, during this ceremony, the Brahmins or the concerned Hindu families, they have to transport the idols, you understand, statues of Lord Rama and Sita to the center of the pond where actual place of this ceremony was situated, which was called Ram Teerth. Being a Muslim family, they were never lagging behind, that they will not participate in this kind of ceremony. But rather what they were doing, they were wholeheartedly and with dedication participating in this ceremony, and they used to arrange a boat so that the people could sit in that boat and can transport their idols to the center of the pond. And events from Ramayana and from the life of prophet related to Muslim saint, were the bedtime stories my mother and grandmother would tell the children in our family. So the third example given here, that they have respect for every religion, was that during bedtime stories, his grandmother used to tell him the stories of Lord Rama, from the life of Lord Rama, as well as prophet, and there was not any kind of discrimination between the gods of Hindus as well as that of Muslims. So there was not any kind of discrimination, but this is what APJ Abdul Kalam wants to deliver through these paragraphs, that there was not any kind of discrimination that was being held at that time, and people were living in close harmony with each other. Sometimes the question can also be asked that what examples of communal harmony has been given by APJ Abdul Kalam in the chapter My Childhood. Okay, so what you have to imbibe each and every deep knowledge of the chapter. So one day when I was in the fifth standard at Rameshwaram Elementary School, a new teacher came to our class. I used to wear a cap which marked me as a Muslim, and I always sat in the front row next to Ramanand Shastri, who wore sacred thread. So now he is also narrating the incident of his class fifth. So what he is saying, that when he was in class fifth, a teacher came to their school, and because APJ Abdul Kalam was wearing a cap which was discriminating, for which he was easily identified as a Muslim boy, and his other three friends, because they belonged to Brahmin families, they were wearing a sacred thread across their chest, okay, which was called as janeu. The new teacher could not stomach a Hindu priest's son sitting with a Muslim boy, and the new teacher, he was not able to digest this thing, that how a Muslim boy is sitting with that of Hindu priest's son. In accordance with our social ranking, as the new teacher saw it, I was asked to go and sit on the back bench. So the teacher, who has this feeling of discrimination in his mind, he has told me to go to the last desk and sit and get parted with his friend with whom he was sitting for many years. I felt very sad, and so did Ramanand Shah. So both were feeling bad for this kind of discrimination. He looked utterly downcast as I shifted to my seat in the last row. So he was looking with insult in his eyes that I was moving to the last seat. The image of him weeping when I shifted to the last row left a lasting impression on me. And this incident, that he was weeping his eyes because I shifted to the last seat, he said, this left a deep impression, deep mark on my soul and in my heart also. And this is how young childhood memories he has shared, but not without any reason. He has shared it for a purpose, because again he is going to deliver us the feeling that there was not any kind of discrimination, which we will read further tomorrow. And still here we have to do. If you have any doubt, you can ask.